it shores up education. Critics say it pays off his allies in teachers' unions. But the bottom line, $176 million in stimulus money earmarked for Kentucky schools. Evening, everybody. I'm Jack Atherton.
And good evening to you. I'm Cherie Puello. So what will the money be used for, and how much of it will make its way to districts right here in the tri-state? News says Brian Hamrick has our number one story tonight. Brian?
Yeah, Cherie, every school district we talk to welcomes the federal money. It basically evens out what the schools have been losing in state revenue. The specifics are all outlined in the state budget. Just one problem. Kentucky hasn't passed a state budget. At Walton Verona, even in English classes.
And then we'll take this and apply it to the poem by Elizabeth Bishop, The Fish.
It's math that's making people sweat. The upside is the state of Kentucky is getting $176 million in federal stimulus money. That's to be shared among schools across the Commonwealth.
This year, our amount was just under $500,000, which is roughly 10 to 12 teaching positions that without this funding, we would have had to find ways locally to support those classes or make cutbacks.
Kevin Ryan, Walton Verona finance director, says they're like most school districts. They aren't getting extra money, simply breaking even. The federal dollars are like pothole patches, filling in so they don't lose teaching positions. But there's a problem that even computers can't solve. Kentucky has yet to pass a budget, so nothing is certain. It means the school has to prepare to do without, even though they'll likely get the money eventually. For many, it's all a lesson in frustration.
I think teenagers right now are just the uncertainty of the future and wondering if things are going to continue to improve or maybe change in a direction where we're not really sure where they're going to go.
So unfortunately, the needs of the state took a backseat to politics because they couldn't get a budget passed.
So schools prepare for a bumpy road ahead. Even at that, most districts aren't as worried about this year as they are 2011 funding. There's no indication that more federal money is coming. So the only hope to avert cutbacks then is for an uptick in the economy that would increase tax revenue, Cherie.
Brian, I know that the special session to deal with the budget doesn't even begin until after the May primary, but contracts are up for many of these teachers before that, right?
That's a big problem, Cherie. You've got money that in theory is going to be there, but if you sign a contract and for some reason it's not there, the district still has to honor the contract. So many districts are making cuts they hope they don't have to make permanent, Cherie.
Yeah, still hard for those teachers to hear. All right, Brian Hamrick reporting live for us tonight. Brian, thanks.